Welcome back. We have a technology presentation now on with building next generation banking service on AWS to adapt to the new normal. This is by Mr. Kiran Jagannath, head FSI ITS India and Southeast Asia, Amazon Internet Services. Kiran Jagannath is a head of financial services and IT service business of Amazon Internet Service across India and South Asia, helping customers on their transformation journey in the cloud. Kiran has been in the financial service industry for over 25 years. Since he started his career with Citigroup, he spent over 15 years at Citigroup and its subsidiary, spanning senior executive role in US cards, business across marketing, finance and business management. Kiran was heading telecom unit before joining American Express in 2010. It's a short stint spanning a year of half an American Express. Kiran was a head of marketing, product energy and analytics for the Safe platform, a brand that helped launch at American Express. He joined Oracle as a vice president in the financial service business unit on his return to India in 2011. He was a global head of the risk and finance analyst business in September 2019.
Hi, I'm Kiran Jagannath. I lead the financial services and IT services business for Amazon Internet Services Private Limited for India and South Asia. Today, I wanted to talk to you about some trends we are seeing in the financial services industry and how our customers are navigating changes due to a new normal. We will talk about how AWS is partnering with some of the largest banks, insurance companies, and brokerages on this journey. Firstly, I'd like to talk to you about four themes we see in the industry. Most institutions have always aspired to be customer-centric. As digitization takes center stage, they truly have an ability to offer distinct experiences to different customers based on their behaviors, ushering an era of hyper-personalization in banking. With the country going through rapid digitization, financial services customers now truly have an ability to offer an end-to-end digital user experience on many of the customer journeys. Policies like allowing video KYC has made onboarding very seamless and friction-free. One just needs a smartphone and a mobile data signal to open checking, savings, or a credit card account at some of the leading banks. This has led to significant reimagining of systems like digital lending, loan originations and management, online savings account, wealth management, account aggregators, marketing automation solutions, all of which are launched on our cloud platform. As experiences go digital and the need for personalization intensifies, data strategies have come back into focus. Many financial services customers have embarked on revamping their data strategies and opted to leverage data lakes and agile analytics use cases to enable personalization using customer 360 views and HPC that are scaled on cloud. AML use cases are being leveraged for eKYC and video KYC, document processing solutions, call center intelligence solutions, and ML is fast driving underwriting models, fraud detection models, to name a few. All these leverage cloud to be more scalable and highly available. And what's more, our financial services customers have started modernizing their core systems, like core banking, core insurance, core lending, learning management systems, treasury, CRM. These are fundamental building blocks towards building a digital first institution. Customers like Bajaj Finserv, HDFC Life, and others have leveraged cloud effectively to drive more seamless partner integrations, including with fintechs, through better API management and scaling payments platforms. What is driving this shift in India? Consumers increasingly expect personalization, convenience, and an enhanced user experience. A recent EY study indicated that 87% of digitally native Indian consumers have already adopted fintech solutions. A Forrester study suggests that 59% of metro Indian consumers are willing to move to digital-only banks in the next 2 years. Yes, digital-only banks in just the next 2 years. Keep in mind that these metros are where a lot of the physical branches are concentrated. So financial services customers are readjusting their strategies where digital channels become the primary channel of customer engagement. Customer engagement isn't as simple as it used to be. As customer preferences have evolved and physical interaction is limited or difficult, like we saw during the pandemic, digital user engagement is critical for financial services companies to effectively communicate with and reach their customers with the right message at the right time and through the right channels. Customers want to be able to easily check their claim or transaction status or secure their accounts, monitor it, access personalized offers, get instant account balances or fraud alerts, or simply be able to ask questions to service themselves anytime, anywhere. As an example, during the pandemic, when physical branches were shut and contact center employees were not able to reach their employee locations, Kotak Bank reimagined their conversational experience, leveraging voice and AIML that powered similar experiences, no matter the digital channel of choice of the customer. Cloud is becoming a part of the new normal to enable all of these transformations. These are some of the key trends that we see across the globe, including in India. The first four especially are gaining significant traction in India. When we speak of new digital channels, it's beyond hosting websites and creating mobile applications. Customers are also creating an alternative to the broker agent model in insurance, as an example, to appeal to younger consumers. Similarly, in banking, Axis Bank launched their first end-to-end digital onboarding experience to open a fully digital savings account called Leap, all on AWS. Data lakes are making it so much easier to perform analytics while saving on storage in the process. We are seeing organizations like FINRA use a data lake to save money while improving their market surveillance. We are seeing some global brands streamline their regulatory reporting on the cloud. And insurers are performing customer sentiment analysis to provide better experiences. For example, in India, HDFC Life implemented their data platform on AWS that facilitated an agile and responsive solution to deliver a frictionless onboarding experience to their customers. When it comes to machine learning, AWS continues to make it easier for organizations to implement it. We are seeing this across the board, whether it's back office, front office, new use cases are emerging every single day. Fraud detection, sales recommendations, contract analysis, loan and insurance underwriting. The sky is the limit. Customers have truly embraced AIML across every aspect of their business, like analyzing thousands of documents per quarter for risk assessment, facial recognition for work from home of employees during the pandemic, and contact center AI to analyze recordings of customer service calls, or even topics like building a resume parser to classify and rank CVs from a large pool of candidates. All this has required our customers to also focus on core system modernization. We are seeing a number of our customers migrate their core systems to the cloud in an effort to gain agility and break free from costly, slow legacy architectures. It's really necessary for companies that are investing in digital innovation to first modernize their core systems. Now let's talk about how AWS is helping banks and financial services transform to meet these growing needs. But first, a little bit of history. We started building our team in 2011, and now we have spent a decade of our presence in India. We are now the undisputed choice of almost all the fintech platforms who started their journey on AWS. We have 20 plus insurance customers who have either migrated to AWS or built their digital platforms on AWS. We have more than 9 private banks who are aggressively innovating and migrating to AWS. We also have a large number of NBFCs, brokerages, mutual funds, and stock exchange customers who are building data lakes, migrating applications, and building digital platforms on AWS, including trading platforms. We launched our Mumbai region a few years ago and have already announced that we're working on a second region to launch sometime next year to cater to these growing needs. These customers who you see on the screen have become the go-to logos for many others. Customers who reposed their faith in us early are innovating at a much faster clip. Starting with just one, two service, many of these customers now have adopted a whole host of AWS services. Let's go deeper into what some of these leaders are doing on cloud. Axis Bank is going through a large digital transformation, reimagining every aspect of their business on the cloud. In fact, at the recent AWS Summit India Online, Mr. Amitabh Chaudhary, CEO of Axis Bank, shared a very aggressive goal of moving more than 70% of their applications to AWS in the next 24 months. I already spoke about HDFC Live starting the journey with Data Lake, but they quickly expanded to provide personalized experiences before deciding to go all in with AWS. Bajaj Allianz General Insurance, who started their cloud journey very early, went in for a complete modernization of their core to become a digital-first insurance company. RBL Bank recently announced that they have selected AWS as the preferred cloud provider to drive their AI capabilities. They're using machine learning to drive significantly differentiated customer experience along with an all-in migration to the cloud. AWS is making it very cost-effective and easy to innovate. Our cloud platforms allows enterprises to rapidly stand up dev test environments and then experiment with new ideas across lines of businesses. These ideas could involve products, services, or even involve creating new risk management solutions. Enterprises are able to develop these products and services quickly and then continuously refine them, leading to an enhanced customer experience, which in turn generates valuable new data. And then the flywheel turns again, fueling additional experimentation. So we've got a virtuous cycle of agility breeding innovation, which breeds new ideas. And we are seeing this phenomenon enacted across the industry. You heard a few examples of what our customers are doing in the areas of enhanced customer experience, leveraging data lakes for personalization, using AML to enrich customer conversations, like we heard about at RBL, or what IndusInd and Bajaj Finserv are doing to build integrated propositions that involve a broader ecosystem as they matured their API platform to make enterprises much more open, providing a very robust engine to the ecosystem. A lot of these customers leverage our hackathons, game days, immersion days, culture of innovation, and working backwards workshops to drive enterprise-wide innovation. While we have talked about innovation and customers driving many of their digital transformations in partnership with AWS, I would like to mention that security and compliance continues to be day zero activity for us. Security and resiliency are our highest priorities. The advantage that AWS has in the way we innovate, we have a large number of customers on our platform and we listen intently. We offer our customers a highly secure cloud computing environment and a range of tools and resources that are immediately useful and effective for customers to leverage as they build and implement their own application level security measures. AWS has achieved a number of internationally recognized certifications and accreditations, demonstrating compliance with third-party assurance frameworks, including those that impact most financial services organizations, such as PCI DSS for payments, GDPR for privacy, and a host of other certifications that can be easily found on our website. AWS customers also have access to governance-focused, audit-friendly service features to meet regulations and audit standards. We understand the unique security, regulatory, and compliance obligations financial services institutions face on a global scale. AWS customers can access controls that have been tested, validated by third-party auditors across ISO, PCI, SOC, and other certifications. Our security and compliance experts can also help customers create scalable, secure cloud platforms, specially designed to complement the organization's security goals, strategies, and tactics while meeting the strictest regulatory requirements. They will partner with you to help you create a scalable, secure cloud environment that meets your internal and external needs. But you don't have to do this alone. AWS aims to provide the widest range of technology and consulting partner solutions to help financial institutions achieve their cloud objectives. The AWS Partner Network is the global partner program for AWS, helping AWS partners build successful AWS-based business practices and solutions. With their deep expertise on AWS, these partners are uniquely positioned to an organization at any stage of their cloud journey. APN partners with the AWS Financial Services competency offer solutions custom built for financial institutions to manage risk, streamline operations, and sustain growth. In summary, AWS provides a breadth of services, deepest functionality, and automation that enables firms to securely and cost-effectively modernize their legacy systems and transform to be digital-first institutions. Thank you, and we look forward to partnering with you on your digital transformation journey.
Thank you, Mr. Kiran Jagannath. It was a very good presentation by AWS. Now we move on for the next panel discussion, which is on role of cloud and other disruptive technologies in ensuring digital transformation. Stay tuned, we'll be right back in 5 minutes.